Yo, it's your boy, got the whole squad behind me, back again with another daily video. As you can see here, I got LR Goku at the helm, got your girl, Majin Vegeta. He's transgender, he's trying to work through some things, he got, like, he's suicidal and shit, want to blow himself up, don't judge him. Got your guy, LR Broly, 100% natural, nigga does zero steroids, unless you count the steroids he takes, in that case, then it's not zero. So here we go. We gon' ching chong bing bong shalaba laba ding dong. You have been invited to the 21st World Tournament. Thank you. I appreciate it greatly. Woo! Alright. I don't even remember what this guy says. Yo, advance all the way to the finals. Make sure you defeat... Damn, you saw how many Gregories that was? Make sure you defeat your rivals. You can get this fucking two kids in a suit. And these shitty SSRs that no one cares about. Yeah, okay. Nigga, shut the fuck up. Act like I can read and shit. So, as you can see, we is ready, baby. Ooh, preliminary. Come on, man. You know you want to give me a Broly. Get out. Whoa, 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 whoa. Nigga, I don't care about your dupe stats. You better be... Alright, he's SA20. Fair enough. I probably should change this up. And I think I'm going to play super cautiously, because I remember last World Tournament, I kind of was like, I don't know, I was just like, fuck it, they're not going to super me, they're not going to attack me, they're not going to do this, they're not going to do that. And then at the end of the day, guess what happens, I got supered in the fucking face, and I'm an asshole, I'm an asshole, I'm an asshole. But the good thing is, I don't have to bring a Senzu Bean, just because of the fact this Goku gets like, what, 7k HP per red orb, or every orb? Where the fuck? Okay, this changes blue to red, which is good, I guess. This changes blue to green. Maybe it's better I don't take that and take green to blue. Okay, that's good enough, I think. And then I'll just bring this fucking bullshit just in case. And I'll bring a ghost usher, even though I'm probably not gonna need that, especially on this low level. But still, you never know. You never know. You just don't know. Let's see. Alright. I don't know why the fuck this nigga has... you know what, low key? I should have just done a full LR team, because I'm pretty sure the way this works, at least at the beginning, is like it ranks you based off of like who is around you and shit. Who's coming? That guy's coming. I have two... Okay, Broly's on the other turn. Eh, whatever, I'll just... Whatever gives a shit. I was gonna let this nigga super, but what's the difference? Really, 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 what's the difference, really? And honestly, Majin Vegeta, I kind of didn't realize this until now, is ridiculously strong, because this nigga, I think I either have him at SA15, maybe now, but in the past I had him at SA10. That nigga always did like a milli damage. That's a lot of damage for an SA10 LR, nigga. Because you get him to SA20, you know that man's putting in at least 1,000,005. He's doing that overtime, getting that pay up, Negro. Nigga's got to be home at 11, Negro's at 12. Shout out to Nas. He actually made a pretty decent album. I actually thought his album was going to be shit. Kind of like Kanye's album. Ye is, I don't know, I'm not feeling Ye. I'm not on that new Ye wave. Let me see. Are you kidding me, man? All I need is fucking, like, one more. And, like, this... Alright, you know, this is what we're gonna do. This is what we're gonna do, right? We're gonna block with this nigga, right? We're gonna block with this nigga. Then, we're gonna super with this guy. Alright, cool. We're Gucci. We're super Gucci, Louie Louie. But yeah, like I was saying, Ye's album is pretty shit. Didn't like it. Pusha T's album was... okay, I thought I did. Pusha T's album was half garbage. The only thing he had good was What Would Meek Do? And then his diss track to fucking Drake. That shit was amazing. That shit was amazing. Let's keep with the facts. You are hiding a child. And I thought that nigga was lying, and then I googled that shit. I'm like, yo, my man Drake is hiding a baby on the low. That's some... That's... My nigga Drake, he's more dark-skinned than light-skinned, believe it or not. Because everybody knows, the darker you are, the worse you are. Ever since... Cain and Abel. Nigga, don't call me when I'm trying to record a video. I'm actually supposed to be at work right now. I technically am at work right now. But I'm working from home, and I'm taking a, like, I don't know, 20-minute break. Because I didn't really, do any thing for lunch. I just ate a sandwich that took 5 minutes. And so I have an hour lunch break, but whatever. I got shit to do. It doesn't really matter. Papa Americano. I was about to say, I could have sworn I had enough. Like, I knew I had enough. Yeah, so like I was saying, I'm at work right now, working from home. I'm doing pretty damn good with what I'm doing. Actually working a little bit with Spark's Databricks API. It's just like a REST client, but it's pretty cool because basically what I have to do is figure out, like, they basically have a job that they run, and it goes from AWS, it gets triggered, goes to Databricks, and then it basically does some magical stuff, and it ends up in a Dynamo database. And a lot of times, if this does fail, it's kind of ambiguous, and you don't know why or when it failed or what the fuck happened. So I'm basically just going through, making sure that it executes properly. On success, you go check the Kinesis stream, see that it's working. Go check Dynamo, see if it's in there. So it's pretty much just like a fail-safe check for the most part. It's pretty cool, though, because it's a distributed system, and my program basically is looking at it from the outside. It's not... This is something that's kind of simple if you're doing like a client host type of thing where you just get the response and then go look at whatever you want to look at. But I actually have to run the job. I have to then list all the jobs, get the run ID, and then after getting the ID, then actually query that ID and wait for it to be done. So it's kind of a long test. It'll probably take more than likely 3 minutes to execute. No, probably three or four minutes. But at least it serves as some type of like safeguard and something that these dudes, when they run it, they're like, all right, this actually works properly. What do you know? Dude! And I'm actually pretty happy because at my job, I've been doing pretty good. I've been elite. I've been an elite man. Anything they need me to do, I'll do it. Like, I don't give a shit. Like, for the past 2 weeks, I was Mr. Performance, man. Like, this, like, one of the architects was like, yo, man, I'm trying to finish this performance job to see how well this Lambda can execute and this stream can execute, blah, 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 on this endpoint. I'm like, yo, man, I got you. I know JMeter. And I'm not talking about the GUI. The GUI is all right, but I know the API, boy, for, I don't know if I mentioned this, but API for JMeter is really ambiguous and vague, and there's literally no documentation. I don't know why they chose to not make any documentation. They're just like, fuck it, it's, you know, self-explanatory, when it's not really. But it's something that I was working on in the past, and they asked me to do it now because that's something I'm familiar with. And that guy was dumb happy. He's like, dude, you know the API? And I'm like, yes, sir, I know the API. I actually had to basically, in the program itself, you have to, create your own request handler. So, like, for JMeter, like, say you do a get request to Google, who gives a shit? You're sending it to Google, you use theirs. But because we're sending it to our own customized application, you have to sign it where AWS is signing. I think it's AWS fucking whatever. S4. And basically then send the request. So the problem is that you can't just do a get request or a post. You need to sign your shit properly. So that's what my program does. It basically uses their signing mechanism. I was actually going to write my own signing mechanism, but thankfully they already did it. So I'm like, fuck it. That's actually pretty annoying because then you get into... If you're ever interested in all this Dokkan hacking elite shit that fucking your boy Renzi does, that's a lot of what it has to do with OAuth authentication as well as signing and timestamps and making sure that your request is properly signed so that it actually goes through. So that's something that I did. I made a customized sampler for that. It was really cool, honestly. Anytime I get to make like something that works with another program, and especially if it's GUI, something with a GUI, as childish as it sounds, I just like seeing that. It's fucking cool. So I was happy to work on that. And dude, my manager, just know, my self-esteem went super up because she's like, dude, listen, I see you. I see what you're working on. I see what you're doing. You're doing a lot of shit you're not really supposed to do. Like, you're not expected to do this. Like, I was doing performance stuff. I did a little bit of security stuff. I did a little bit of fucking just some random programming for another team and a different team. And she's like, yo, I see you. Just know the mid-year reviews are coming and I'm going to recommend you for a promotion, sir. I'm like, ooh, I appreciate that. I was happy that she said that, honestly, because I don't know how the fuck promotions, like say if she didn't say that, I know I've been doing a lot of shit, and I've been putting in work, I've been doing a lot of shit, like, I've been, just know, one of my teammates went out for a week, and he was supposed to do something, bro, that sicko had 2 weeks to finish it, he did zero, I picked that shit up, I did it in, like, half a week, and I'm like, ooh, I'm a nice completionist, what the fuck is this? Ooh. Whoa, that's actually pretty good. At least for surviving KO attacks. Yeah, so the point is, like, I'm a cuck. Like, I have low self-esteem. I'm not, like, what am I supposed to say? I'm supposed to go in there and be like, hey, I've been doing good. Can I get a raise? Oh, how much do you want? I'm like, I don't know. But she's like, yo, trying to get you a nice promotion. I'm like, ooh. She's like, send me an email of, like, things that you think is extra, things that you think are, you know, exemplary, blah, blah, blah. And I'll hook you up. And that was about 2 weeks ago, and I never sent to the email. So low-key, I'm going to get passed over. But, you know what they say? A man is based on his merit, right? Fuck that. I got to send her that email. I'm trying to get that guapo, nigga. Right now, just know. My money situation, ooh, super shit. Super, just know I'm making bills, but I'm fucking paying bills. Just know. Dude, my parents get me so, like, I want to box the shit out of my parents. Like, I just get a job, right? This is literally what they say to me, right? I was thinking, like, yeah, I'll help out with some bills. You know, $1,000 a month, maybe $2,000 a month. I don't care. Who gives a shit? Actually, $2,000 a month, that's crazy. Calm the fuck down. But I'm like, whatever. Boy, who gives a shit, right? Bro, just know these niggas are scumbags. Bro, I look, my sister goes to high school, right? And they're in some... they're in some deep genjutsu. They're like, yo, you gotta go to a private school. They're super good. Go to a private school, okay? It's more expensive. I like that. So I look at her school. Yeah, we owe them $7,000. I'm like, yeah? Who's gonna pay it? Yeah, I don't know. Something's gonna happen. And bro, what I love to, like, I swear to God, I've been super fucking stressed out these past couple months. Just because of the fact, like, every 5 seconds my mom is like, my mom went into a different, like, autism does not completely capture the genjutsu she went into. Like, okay, my dad, he went into a deep genjutsu himself. He's like, yo, I gotta marry some random person that I never met before? Sounds like a good idea. So he goes marry some other broad, and then my mom filed for divorce, and she basically, like, she's like, she could do anything. She could take the house, she could fucking make him a slave, do whatever she wants. So every time, like, anything happens, my dad will call me, like, dude, she's trying to take my house. Dude, she's trying to take my paycheck. So, like, all I get, this is all I hear. When something bad happens or a bill comes up and my dad can't afford it, I just hear my mom, I'll go to the police. They'll take it from his paycheck. It doesn't matter. And I'm not saying what my dad did was right, but my dad has shit pay at a shit job with shit time, and he can't fucking afford certain things. And, like, the point is, like, go to the fucking police. Like, go to the court. Go garnish his paycheck. Nigga makes fucking $800 a week maximum. Like, what the fuck do you think you're going to get from that? Oh, that's a lot of fucking... something to look forward to. Some nice, delicioso awakening medals. But, fuck you. That's completely fucked up my flow. But the point is, he doesn't make that much, so her going and trying to, like, exacerbate things isn't really going to help anything. But they just look, bro, I'm like, listen, I'm a realist, right? My dad pays the fucking bills. If this nigga's paying for dumb shit, that's it, we're cooked. Like, nigga, I make good money, but I don't make good money to support a fucking family of five, nigga. Like, what am I, a family man now? So I just basically just been paying their bills whenever my dad can't. And that's more times than not. Like, just know, I paid a hot $7,000 for her school. I paid a hot $2,000 out of nowhere for some bullshit. And then, bro, here's the thing, right? Like, my mom gets me so heated because she does so much dumb shit for, like, no reason. Like, here's the thing, right? My sister's school wasn't paid. $7,000, I paid $3,000. And then there was another, like, $4,000 on the table, right? My mom has the balls. My sister was graduating high school. She invites 15 people, right, to go to a dinner. And she's like, yay, dude, come to this dinner. We're going to have a dinner. It's a graduation dinner. And I'm like, all right, whatever. Use this shit. It's a dinner, whatever. And then she's like, come. Don't pay anything. I'll pay for everything. I'm like, hold up. this bitch invited 15 people to a restaurant that's pretty expensive, and she's gonna pay for everything. But when she said she pays for everything, she means my dad pays for everything. But because my dad doesn't have any money, that means I pay for everything. Bro, I wanted to roundhouse fucking kick my mom in the throat. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? What the fuck, man? Like, what the fuck? Like, I don't understand what was going through her mind. So, it ends up that night, because, you know me, I like making people happy. I don't like beef. I don't like strife. I ain't trying to end up like XXXTentacion. I ain't trying to get squat and shot and shit or shat. So, I end up paying the fucking bill. $650 fucking dollars, my nigga. That's with tips. $650. Think about that. I have a car payment that's $430 every month. I spent more than a fucking car payment on that dinner. And my mom's like, yeah, it's a graduation. It only happens every once in a lifetime. Yeah, my sister's like, yeah, it's a graduation. Why not? I'm like, listen, you fucking retards. We have no money. Do you understand that? Just because I have a job and I make some money that makes us not in debt doesn't mean that we have fucking money. Like, right now in my bank account, it is the shit, like, super shit. Right now, in debt, I think I have like 6.5K, 6,500, right? On a credit card. No interest. I've been paying it off. Okay? And then in my bank account, I think I have like maybe like 9K. 9K maybe. Which isn't that much. That's not that much for all the bills that... This is the thing, though. 6.5K for my bill that I have on my credit card, right? That doesn't take into account the random $400 that comes out of nowhere, the random $200 that comes out of nowhere. Dude, I wanted to, like, fucking Kung Fu Panda slap the shit out of my mom. She came to me, like, 3 weeks ago. She's like, yo, dude, basically what's going on is this. Yeah, so here's the thing. I bought your sister some clothes, right? I bought her some clothes. And the bill ended up being... $1,000. So she just comes out of nowhere and she's like, yeah, there's a bill for $1,000. I'm like, okay. You're shot. Go return some clothes. She's like, dude, she didn't buy clothes for like a year, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, whoa, you're super fucking shot. Just because you don't buy clothes for a year doesn't mean you go out and buy $1,000 worth of clothes when you don't have the fucking money. And we're struggling right now, nigga. We're struggling. Like, this is the thing, right? This is what's crazy, right? I got a job. I got a good paying job. But because my parents are so mentally fucked and so fucking stupid, they went into more debt than they... My mom, right? She got a divorce from my dad, okay? Whatever. They're miserable. They've been miserable forever. I don't know why she decided to get a divorce now. They're still fucking miserable. Whatever. So... She gets a divorce. Now, in the fucking well, I'm on the East Coast, nigga. Most states, especially on the East Coast, it's fucking easy to get a divorce. You go file for it, that's it, it's done. The judge will fucking look at it and be like, all right, bet. Nigga, you're getting divorced. Okay, good. Here, take this amount of money, go. My mom, she's like, no, 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 no. That is not good enough for me. I need a lawyer. So she goes gets a lawyer, but because she's very smart, intelligent, and great, she does not have the money. She goes and takes out a high percentage loan from a credit card. And she has not paid off that credit card. I don't know how long. But the point I'm trying to make is she probably took out $5,000-$6,000 that she didn't have to pay a lawyer that she didn't need. And it's probably going to end up falling on me. So the point I'm trying to make is if the only way right now I wouldn't give a shit that like my parents are fucking retarded and spend like 10K in 2 months because they're fucking retarded, is if I was making 100K a year and I've been working for 2 years and had a savings, like, saved up. But I've been working since October, my boy. Ock-fucking-tober. And you'd think I've been working for 1-2 months. Because thing is, like, I have not paid. The only thing I bought one thing that, like, since I got my new job, I'm like, yo, you know what? A lot of my friends, they have a PS4. They've been fucking hounding me to get one. I'm like, fuck it. I'm making guapo. Let me buy this PS4. Just know that shit was $300 with the game. I have not bought anything else because I'm fucking, I'm worried that magically there's going to be a new bill, I need some fucking money, and I'm going to be missing that $300-$400. And, like, the thing is, like, that's, like, I shouldn't be worrying about this. Like, this is not my fucking responsibility. Like, my parents are fucking children. Like, they're fucking, they're so nuclear, zapping my fucking energy. Like, legit, I wanted to, from, since December, I've been thinking of buying a, like, a better PC. Either a gaming PC or a high-performing PC. Something that is a decent PC. My laptop is from 2010, and it's a laptop. It's shit, right? But my parents have put so much stress and fucking tension on my head, I don't want to spend a fucking penny that I don't know 100% that I'm not going to need. Like, right now I could pay off my credit card debt and I have a couple thousand left over, but I don't fucking know what's going to fucking happen. I don't know when some magic fucking number is going to come out and I'm going to have to pay for it. I have no fucking clue. It's fucking ridiculous and it's fucking aggravating. And to be honest, it's probably caused more stress in my life than fucking a number of years, and it's been pretty annoying and pretty, I don't want to say depressing, but fucking just know, nigga, if this shit went on for like another 6 months, like now it's starting to slow down, and I'm starting to not give up, like I'm real, like I'm being real with you, if my dad just comes to me and he's like, listen, I didn't say this, right, I didn't want to say anything, but on the low, all right, okay, I've been drug dealing on the side. Your mother found out, right? I'm gonna lose my job. You gotta do this. You gotta do that. But like, listen, I'm fucking done. I have no fucking energy left. Do whatever the fuck you need to do. Like, I'm spent. Like, my dad zapped the shit out of me. Like, this nigga used to call me every fucking day, and he'd be like, dude, your mom, she's trying to do this. She's trying to do that. You gotta do this. I'm like, this nigga, apparently they bought like some shitty fucking dog shit house down the shore, and like my mom co-signed for it, whatever the fuck, and he's like, dude, she's trying to take the house, and he wanted me to go drive down there, go look at the house, see how shit it is, convince your mother, tell your mother, she only listens to you, and then like after he realized she doesn't give a shit about me or him, he's like, yo, dude, my dad went into like a deep Genjutsu, he's like, yo, I don't have to work for this, like I'm paying the bills anyway, like he honestly, he's not a scumbag. He's a hard worker. He pays the bills. Obviously, he's on some Genjutsu shit. This nigga goes out and marries some fucking bitch out of nowhere. I honestly think I'm still in denial about that fact because I refuse to, like, think about it. I legit just don't think about it. Like, if like, someone were to tell me, he's like, yo, I heard your dad has another wife. I'm like, nigga, I don't know what you're talking about. I never heard of that. Nah, nigga, I don't know what you're talking about. But the point being, that nigga zapped my fucking will to live. Nigga used to call me at work. Used to call me all the fucking time. Like, I'm the goddamn financial and fucking marital counselor. So, I'm fucking done. If something happens, an emergency happens, if it's something I can deal with, I can deal with it. But I'm not about to go into fucking debt, like, just to make my parents happy for some dumb shit just because they're fucking retarded. And, like, I keep bailing them out and they're fucking, like, they're retarded. Like, they keep spending money on dumb shit, like... Like, the fact that I spent all that money, like, I spent $4K in one weekend on school, and it's not even my school, it's my sister's school, and then, like, the next week, they're like, yeah, and you're gonna go to dinner, we're gonna have 15 people go, and you're gonna pay for it, and I know what would've happened if I didn't pay for that bill. Listen, that $650, I would've paid $3,000, I would've burned that fucking money, because I know that if I didn't pay that dinner, I wouldn't hear the end of it. My mom would have lost her fucking mind because she's fucking retarded. And she'd be like, listen, your father doesn't pay the bills. He doesn't pay for the dinner. That's fucking retarded. That shit. I gotta go to court. I gotta go back to the lawyer. I gotta spend thousands of more dollars. And I gotta go do that, dude. And I'm like, Betty, go do that, boss. Great idea. So, fuck it. $650? I don't give a fuck. If I knew that nothing else would come up and there's no more bullshit, I'd take all the money out of my fucking bank account and burn it. I don't give a fuck. The point is, I have zero tolerance for energy draining, and these niggas been draining me since fucking December. Like, they haven't stopped draining for, the minimum draining has been as of late. Like, as of late, it hasn't been that bad. But I know these niggas. Bro, twice in this 6 month period, I thought like the draining was over. When the divorce was over, like this is the thing, divorce is over. I thought, all right, bet, we're good. We're good. We're Gucci. All right, my energy about to go back up. Then all of a sudden in court, my mom finds out there's some bitch that fucking like took the mail, and she's like, "Who's this bitch?" My dad's like, "I don't know who the fuck that is." And then it turns out he's like, "Yeah, I married some bitch on the side." And that was like a super explosion. That was a fucking, like, I thought everything was over. I thought it was fucking done. Like, nigga, like that, like the divorce was Nagasaki, right? And then like on my Japanese ass, I'm like, "Yo, alright, Nagasaki hit, right? It was some crazy shit. But, you know, we can survive one nuclear bomb. We can keep going, okay? Let's just keep going. Oh, here come Hiroshima. Here come the Enola Gay dropping another atomic bomb. I can't take two. I definitely can't take three. Nigga, Japan couldn't take two nuclear bombs. If Japan can't take two nuclear bombs, I can't take no fucking three nuclear bombs, nigga. That's fact. Just know, if another nuclear bomb comes, I keep it real, I'm about to move the fuck out, and I'm about to pretend like nothing, like there's no problems, my family's happy, everybody's Gucci, there's no issues, like I'm just gonna be chilling, cause I don't have the fucking energy, I don't have the fucking time, and honestly, I'm starting to fucking not have the sympathy, cause I don't know, if you wanna be a fucking retard, be a fucking retard. I mean, they're my parents, but Jesus Christ, like, have some fucking responsibility. Like, why the fuck am I all of a sudden the goddamn protector? And I'm the nigga who's got to come through with fucking fat racks. I'm dropping fucking racks. Like, rappers drop this shit on hoes. I'm dropping this shit on fucking education bills and fucking gas and electric bills. Like, nigga, what the fuck do I look like? A goddamn workaholic father of five? Nigga, get the fuck out of here. But that's pretty much it. Shit's pretty legit. Hey, like I said, possible promotion in the works. If I get that promotion, that'd be great. That'd be an extra, I don't know, maybe, possibly 15K a year, maybe. So, fuck it, man. If I get the promotion, good for me. Maybe I'll make up some of the fucking money I lost. If I don't, whatever, who gives a shit? By the time I'm done paying off these bills, it's gonna be like I got a fucking promotion any motherfucking way. So, at the end of the day, what can I say? Words of wisdom, words of advice. Always be careful. Always look out for yourself, because believe it or not, friends, family, fucking spirits, the only person who's really looking out for you is yourself. And if you don't fucking take the initiative and have the willpower to fucking do what's best for you, no one else is gonna fucking do it for you.